Hello and welcome to all. In this video, we will learn about accounts payable in SAP. But before we start, if you are not yet subscribed to our My Support Solutions YouTube channel, then click on the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you will get the latest updates after every new video upload. This is totally free. Please like and share this video, share the knowledge, sharing is caring. Now let us start. So in this video, we will learn about accounts payable in SAP. We will do the following steps. First of all, create vendor account group, maintain vendor number range, create vendor document number range for KA, KR and KZ respectively. Then create two general ledger accounts. One is for accounts payable and second is for credit purchase. Okay. Then create a vendor in FK01. Then create a credit purchase. And last, make a payment. So all these are configuration steps, and we will create these steps one by one. So first of all, create vendor account group. I will follow the menu path, SPRO, press enter, click on IMG button, financial accounting. Financial accounting, okay. Then accounts receivable and accounts payable, vendor accounts, master data. In master data, we have to select preparations for creating vendor master data and define account group with screen layout vendors. Here we can define our vendor account group, create vendor account group. Okay, so here we have already defined our vendor group. Okay, for domestic vendors, we have to click if we want to define a new group, then we have to click on the new entries button. Okay, and here we can define the group code and the name. Okay, since we have already defined this group, see here. We have already defined our vendor group, domestic vendor. Okay. Now second step. Second step, maintain vendor number range. Okay. See, I will take a back and create number range for vendor accounts. So execute. Click on the change intervals. Here we have to click on the insert interval to create a insert a number range. So here we will insert a number range for our vendor account group. Okay, see we have select this number range. Now 22 number range. Now we will save the record. See. Yes, continue and save. We already saved the record. I will take back. Now we have to assign this number range to our vendor account group. Okay, in this first step we have defined our vendor account group. In this second step we have created a number range for our vendor account, and in this step we have to assign the number range which we have created in this step to our vendor account group. Okay, so I will click on the execute button. Assign number range for vendor account groups. Now here click on the position button, put your vendor account group, and here we have to assign the number range which we have just now created. Find and select the respective number range 22 and save the record. Okay. Now we will create a vendor document number range for KA, KR and KZ document type. Transaction code is OBA7. So I will use /N OBA7. Press enter and we will create the document number range if not earlier created. So click on the position, document number KA. K for vendor document. Double click. 17 number range. Click on the number range information. Here we have to put our company code. Okay. I will display interval. 17 number range is already created. If not, we have to see. If you have not yet created this 17 number range, then click on the change intervals, insert interval, and here give your number range, for example 17, year, and number range, that is from number and to number respectively. But in our case, we have already defined this number range, so no need to again create it. Okay, so right now I will cancel this because we have already created this number range. Now see KR, double click invoice, vendor invoice, 19 number range, company code, change intervals, display interval, as I have already created this number range before, so this is our number range. Okay, 19 number range. Now KZ, that is vendor payment, 15 number range, click on number range information, company code, and this is 15 number range interval. Okay, so we have completed this step, create vendor document number range. Now create two general ledgers, one for accounts payable and another is for credit purchase. Okay, creation of general ledger, we have to use a transaction code FS00. Okay, so now see, accounts payable, okay, is our liability, so we have to use a liability group, and here see, this is our accounts payable. So how to create this GL? See, in type description we have to select our liability group. Obviously it is a balance sheet account, accounts payable. In control data, this will be your currency, and here this is a reconciliation account. Okay, so here we have to select a vendor. Now in create bank interest, fee status group is for G061, this is for reconciliation account, then we have to save the record. So this is our accounts payable general ledger. Now second general ledger is credit purchase. Okay, so credit purchase is our expense, hence we have to create a credit purchase account. See here, I will, so this is my credit purchase one account, so I will copy this and I will create a separate credit purchase account. Okay, 30 number credit purchase. Okay, type description credit purchase one, I will remove that credit purchase. And I will save the record. So we have created our credit purchase GL account. Okay, this is our credit purchase GL account. Now we will create a vendor. We will create a vendor in FK01 transaction code. Okay, so I will use here /NFK01, press enter to create a vendor. Put this field blank. Here we have to give our account group, press enter, then select company, CT vendor, okay, country, then customer, bank account, reconciliation account. Here we have to give our reconciliation account which we have created. This is our accounts payable. Here we will select cash management A1. Okay, payment terms as pay immediately, and we will save the record. Save our customer detail. Okay. See, we have created a customer. Oh, sorry, we have created a vendor. Vendor 104501 was created. Now see, now we will create a vendor. We will create a credit purchase. To create a credit purchase, we will use a transaction code F-43 or FB60. So right now I will use a transaction code slash. Just a minute. Slash NF-43. Press enter. Now enter vendor invoice 2703, today's date, document type KR. Here we have to select vendor ABCD which we have just now created. Here give amount, here give text wing. Okay, select credit purchase general ledger account. Posting key will be 40. So I will select credit purchase . This is a credit purchase account which we have created. Okay, give the star mark here, give the plus sign for text, save the record. See, document 9025 was posted. Now we will check the vendor report FBL1N/N FBL1N to vendor balance, vendor line item balance. So this is our vendor. Select open line items and click on the execute button. So in this step we will check the vendor line item. See, this is 25,000. Okay, vendor line item display. Now we will make a payment slash NF-53 to make a payment. Post outgoing payment 2719, bank account. Here give the respective amount 25,000 in account, vendor account key for vendor. Okay, select the vendor and click on process open items. Now system will show the open items. See, 25,000 amount enter and amount assign is 25,000. Okay, so we will save or post outgoing payment. So this is a document 4014 was posted. So this is the process of accounts payable in SAP. If you have any suggestions or queries regarding this video, please feel free to comment. Again, thanks for watching. Keep in touch and bye-bye.